Hi, this is Mananmani from Tamil Nadu Agricultural University, India. The gist of my research is, under water limited condition, I am going to convert the sad plant into a happy plant. Let me ask a question. Can we live without water? Of course, the answer is no, because every organism requires water for its life, including plants. Among plants, my focus is on rice and its water requirement, because rice is considered as a major staple food consumed by more than one-third of the world population. And being a water-loving crop, rice requires approximately 3,000 liters of water to produce a kg of rice. We need to have a balance between food production as well as water requirement. Everybody attending this conference definitely know what is meant by drought. So the major agricultural problem which I am going to deal is also drought. Drought is considered as a leading threat which affects rice crop production. Being a developing country like India, for rain-fed agriculture, we solely depends upon rainfall for crop production. Even extreme rainfall or hardly no rainfall leads to complete crop failure. If severe drought hits the rice crop at its reproductive stage, we can expect the yield loss up to 100%. So in order to attaining the self-sufficiency under severe drought condition, there is a need to develop a better tolerant variety without yield penalty. To achieve this, we have to understand the mechanism of tolerance. That is how plants respond to the stress. That is the main thing we have to understand. So what could be my role as a plant breeder to solve the problem? So we have to feed a billion people even under climate resilient condition. There are different plant breeding techniques available to develop a drought tolerant variety. But unfortunately, it takes around 14 to 15 years to develop a drought tolerant variety. That too to cope up with the climate change. So I choose mutation as the best option to create novel variation in a short span of time. So based on my title, I frame this objective, which starts that I will screen the mutants for drought and I will identify the best one that will be further proceeded to the MutMap population. And finally, the gene pertaining towards the drought, I will identify. Then coming to the mechanism, the most important mechanism for drought is drought avoidance. There are three important characters which is pertaining to the drought avoidance. One is longer root, another one is partial closure of stomata, and the third one is partial leaf rolling. These three is very important while pertaining towards drought. And this is my research work, which starts from Nagina 22 mutation. Then it's ended with identification of gene through a recent technology called whole genome sequencing. Here I have screened the 1,000 entries and I got 12 mutant as the best one than parents. Surprisingly, I got a mutant with different root and drought rates. So this is a mutant which I have identified and it is named as N22CCDTM766. This mutant performed better than Nagina 22, that is my parent, in terms of early vigor, root architecture, as well as reduced spikelet sterility. Even though there is no water in the surface as well as subsurface area, my mutant will produce longer root and it will tend to absorb water even under the deep water table. And it will use the water effectively, and even under severe drought, my mutant will behave green. So these are all some of the features that I took observation in my mutant. So the mutant which I identified will serve as a problem solver under climatic change. Once this mutant is subjected to identifying the gene, that gene will be transferred into a better agronomic variety to develop a better drought tolerant one. So the water requirement for rice cultivation can be reduced, and surely we can expect the balance between food and water security. Coming to the conclusion, nothing is impossible. Let us bring a change to solve agricultural problems by adopting innovation in science. Thank you. I am ready to answer if there is any.